Combs Chapel, home of hope.
In the name of the Lord, my name is Reverend Daniel Jola Muraya. I am here from Combs Chapel, Roiro. May God shall bless you even as we share the word of grace. I want to share with us the message entitled Slaying the Dragon of Fear. You are going to realize in the kingdom of God, God have called us to greatness. God have called us for wonderful things, for our great destiny ahead, for the mighty things, and so that we can glorify Him here on earth. And even when we shall go to eternity, that we shall be rewarded ahead somewhere. But you are going to realize that we have our adversary, the devil. And this is the one who hindered us from moving toward our destiny. And one of the strongest weapons that the enemy uses, he uses the weapon of fear. He uses the weapon of fear. You are going to realize when you look and you do the study in the scriptures that the enemy uses fear to paralyze us. So we are paralyzed that you cannot be able to do the work of God. If you read in the book of Exodus chapter 14, you are going to realize the Bible says that the children of Israel were almost ready to cross the Red Sea. When they were ready to cross the Red Sea, one of the things they feared that the enemy were behind them. The Red Sea was ahead of them. And they were wondering, how are we going to be able to move? They cried to the Lord. Some maybe they were deciding to go back to Egypt. Others were saying, maybe we die. And others were helpless. They were full of fear. And God came and confronted Moses. I told Moses that despite the fear that you are feeling, you must march ahead. And Moses went ahead and God enabled him. He was able to strike the Red Sea and the way he was there. So the enemy was using fear so that the children of Israel, they shall not be able to break from their bondage. This is the same situation that is happening when you read in the book of Numbers chapter 13, that the Bible says the report of the people who were sent by Moses to go and explore the land. When they were to explore the land, the Bible says they found the people who were there were giants. And they were full of fear. They went back to the people and spread the bad report. And when they spread the bad report, the people were saying that we desire to die in Egypt. Maybe we desire to die wherever we are rather than go ahead. So the enemy used the weapon of fear. And when he used the weapon of fear, God was angry with these people. Because when the fear comes, what happened is that faith is driven away. So God, knowing this thing, he had to come in and even challenge them. They did not believe in God. We see Joshua and Caleb, men of faith, they said, yes, our God is going to help us. But we are going to fight the children of Israel. They did not believe in God. They were so full of fear. They were thinking and they were planning to stone Joshua and Caleb. I may not go to the full story about it because you are going to realize that later the Bible says about Joshua and Caleb, the Bible says they are men of different spirit. Why? They were able to confront their fears and be able to encourage men they can go and take the possession of the land. So fear paralyzes. You can be paralyzed by fear. When you read in the book of Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10, the Bible says, so do not fear, for I am with you. Do not fear, for I am with you. So do not be dismayed, for I am your God. So the Lord is telling the Israelites that instead of being paralyzed by fear, do not fear, for I am with you. God knows that there is a human tendency to fear. When you want to walk with God, fear is there. And it paralyzes us from going to our destiny. Do you remember Jesus Christ in Matthew chapter 25 and even verse 25? He gave a parable of talents. He gave some people money and then he left. And you see this master, the landowner, gave money and left. Then one man who was given one, the Bible says he did not use that talent to bring profit. And what was the excuse the man gave? The Bible says, I was afraid. I was afraid. Why? Because you, master, you are a hard man. You are a hard man. And therefore, I went and looked for a place and I put it there so that I may not lose the talent and I can give it back unto you. And this is the same way it is happening to you and it is happening to me. That you have been given a talent and you are given a gift by God, and sometimes you think God is a hard man. One of the things I found with men, you ask them, are you going to do the ministry of God? Are you going to serve in the church? And majority of them, they tell you, no, no, no. You know, I don't want to joke with God. I don't want to go to that Mother Bahu. I don't do the ministry. Why? That I don't want to shame God. In other words, they say, I am afraid, master. You are a hard man. And therefore, God, I cannot do the ministry. So the fear comes and paralyzes them.
And when this fear can paralyze them, they become unproductive in the kingdom of God. They become unproductive in the Sunday school. They become unproductive in the praise and worship. They become unproductive in every aspect of their life. Why are they becoming unproductive? Because fear paralyzes them. And therefore, for us to go to our destiny, for us to be achieve what God has given us to us, we must slay this dragon, which is called fear. This demonic power of darkness, we must fight it and fight it and fight it so that we can go to our promised land, so that we can be able to cross our Red Sea, so that we can be able to say, yes, yes, we came, and we can be able to receive what God has given us to us. Therefore, my brother and my sister, you have to raise against the spirit of fear. I must raise against the spirit of fear, and I must confront this dragon, and I must arise in faith so that I can go to my destiny. I don't desire that you may go to the wilderness for 40 years. The Bible says the Israelites, they stayed in the wilderness for 40 more years. It's because of fear. But what do we see when God wanted to take the promised land? Let's go to the book of Joshua chapter 1. The Bible says, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now then, you and all the people get ready to cross the Jordan River to the land I am about to give to the Israelites. I will give you every place where you set your foot, as I promised Moses. Your territory will extend from the desert to Lebanon and from the great river, the Euphrates, all the country to the Mediterranean Sea in the west. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so will I be with you. I will never leave you, nor will forsake you. Be strong and courageous, because you lead the people to inherit the land I sold to their ancestors to give them. The verse 7 says, be strong and very courageous. Be careful to obey all the rule my Moses gave you. Do not turn to the right or to the left, that you may be successful wherever you go. Keep the book of the law always on your lips. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord will be with you wherever you go. You are going to find that even when they have delayed in the desert for 40 years, now they were about to go to the land of promise. Now they are not going to go to the land of promise through Moses. They are going to go through Joshua. But God, aware of what happened 40 years back, he knew that the Israelites were confronted by the spirit of fear, and they delayed in the desert for 40 years. And now he has tested his power, and even the promises are upon Joshua. Now Joshua, he is the one who is going to fulfill the word of God. But God was aware of this. And what did he tell Joshua? My son, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Be strong and be courageous. Why? If you are not strong and courageous, you will not lead these people to the promised land. The dragon of fear, if it gets hold of you, you and even the children of Israel, perhaps you may not be able to go to the promised land. Therefore, God spoke again and again, do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. This is the same word the Lord is speaking unto you. That maybe your parents, they never enjoyed the promised land. Your father was supposed maybe to be a great man of God. Maybe your mother was supposed to be a great intercessor. Maybe your father or even somebody close to you was supposed to be a great financier of the kingdom of God and maybe the work of God. And therefore, a lot of riches were in his heart or in their head, but they were afraid. They never started that business. They never started that ministry. They never did what God wanted them to do. And therefore, your family and even your life and even their calling, they have stayed and stagnated in the desert for more than 40 years. Now you are the Joshua. And Joshua, God is speaking to you. He is telling you the other generation, they failed. Your mother, your father, they failed. Your brother, your sister, they failed. The other ministers, they failed. And now you are the one who I am going to use so that you can take the people to the promised land. Your children and the generation ahead of you, they need to go to the promised land. But now it is all upon you. And God is speaking unto you and saying, my son Joshua, my servant Moses is dead. Now you are the one going to lead these people to the promised land. But you can fail. You may miss the grace of God. you may miss from entering to the promise. So what is God saying unto you? But you must be strong and courageous. If you go to the church, if you go to the ministry, you must be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid of your voice. Do not be afraid of the little gift that God has given unto you. Do not be afraid that what the people will say when you start ministry. Do not be afraid what will people say about your history. You must be strong and you must be courageous, because you are going to lead your people, you are going to lead your family, you are going to lead the businessmen, you are going to lead the businesswomen to the promised land. But you must be strong and courageous. You must confront this dragon of fear and you must slay it so that you can go to the promised land. The land is flowing with milk and honey, but fear may paralyze you. Maybe you are wondering about your marriage and you say it cannot work. You are saying maybe my family cannot be able to stand. You are saying maybe the disease in our family, we cannot get healed. Maybe you are saying there is maybe this generational curse in our family and the fear is getting hold of you. One of the things God is telling you, do not be afraid, do not be discouraged. Maybe you are praying again and again, and when you pray, you feel as if God is not answering your prayer. The Lord is saying, and God is speaking to you, my son, do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. Why? You are the one who is going to go to the promised land. Do you know you can have fear? One of the fear you have to fight with is the fear of unknown. You may be afraid of things you do not know, and these are what we call what ifs. You have to fight what we call what ifs. If you go to the book of Proverbs chapter 3 and verse 25, the Bible says, have no fear of sudden disaster or the ruin that overtake the wicked, for the Lord will keep you from being ensnared. Sometimes the wicked, they are overtaken by disaster. And therefore, as a servant of God, or even as a child of God, you feel that this thing may come unto me. Maybe it's because of the media being negative. Right now, they speak about diseases, they speak about accident, they speak about fire, they speak so many things. And these are what if that can make you to become a snare. And God says, have no fear of sudden disaster. So there are disasters that may come unexpected. And therefore, majority of us, they fear. They fear, what if maybe I got sick? What if I find myself in an accident? What if my parents, they die? What if maybe I die? This fear, you can be ensnared. And if you're ensnared, you will be unable to become productive in the kingdom of God. There was a story I read somewhere of a woman who was always cautious and afraid that she may get sick and be admitted in the hospital. And what did she do? She had a bag in her house with all the requirements she may need in case she get unwell and get admitted in the hospital. If she gets admitted in the hospital, that she can only maybe take that bag and go to hospital. This is because she was thinking that I can get sick and be unable maybe to move ahead with my life. What if I get sick? And the Bible says that we should not be afraid of this disaster that overtake us. Why? The Lord promises us and says that He will not let our food to be ensnared. One of the things you are going to realize, the Lord will not let your food to be ensnared. So you are going to be walking with steadiness and you are going to move with boldness. That the Lord will keep you from every evil. Your food will not be ensnared. And therefore, to overcome the fear of unknown, you must start on the promise of God that He will not let your food be ensnared. So you will not have that accident. You will not be ashamed. Some of us are in the body of Christ and they want to serve God, but they are afraid. What if I fall into sin? I am going to embarrass the body of Christ, the people who speak about me. I am going to embarrass, my name is going to be known in the social media. And therefore, they sit down instead of confronting the fear of unknown, because they are saying, what if I sin against God? What if my name is paraded in the social media? What if my family say, oh, you have embarrassed them? So they choose quietly to sit down in the house of God. They do not do the ministry because What if I sin against God? What if people speak against me? What if my pastor hates me? What if my family hates me? What if I go to the ministry, I don't get money? What if I don't get breakthrough? What if maybe I say that I go to God to do the work of kingdom and the family member, they raise against me? And therefore, they are choosing the way of Matthew 25 and verse 25. I am afraid, Lord. I am afraid, O Lord. I cannot serve you, Master. Therefore, they are chosen not to serve the Lord. The other fear we have is the fear of known. The fear of known. These are the things that we know. One of the things that we know is the people. In the book of Proverbs 29 and verse 25, the Bible says, the fear of a man will prove to be a snare. But whoever fears the Lord is kept safe. Sometimes there are people we are afraid of. Some of us, we are afraid maybe of our employer. We are afraid of our employer. So most of us, they don't go for prayers because they are afraid. Maybe they are saying that if what if my employer know I am a Christian? What if my customers know I am a Christian? They will take advantage of me. What if they know I am a church guy? They will take advantage of me. So the fear of man will prove to be a snare. We do not know the people around us. There are some even people, they are afraid of political people. They say, this person is bad, this person is not good and such. And therefore they are afraid of them. They are afraid of them. And when they are afraid of them, they have become ensnared. And there we have people who are politically ensnared. It could be a citizen, it could be maybe a politician, but they are held captive by this fear. They are afraid of certain people. They are so much timid. They are so much timid. And the Bible says the fear of a man will prove to be a snare. But the Bible says whoever trusts in the Lord is kept safe. Maybe afraid of your wife, you're afraid of your husband, you're afraid of your pastor, you're afraid of your employer, afraid of your employee, you are afraid of the things that you know. And therefore, the fear of a man will prove to be a snare. What is the solution to this? The Bible says, but whoever fears the Lord is kept safe. So we must know that God is calling us to our destiny. And we have to confront this dragon called fear. The fear of unknown. Right now in our country, ahead of us, there is election of 2020. And one of the things we are going to realize, the many saints, they are afraid of 2022. They are wondering, what if this go this direction, or what if this go to this direction? And therefore, my brother, you are a snare. Maybe Christians are ensnared. Everyone is ensnared because they are looking forward. Right now, it is maybe you are seeing maybe in the media, and we find there is a lot of disconnect in the political world. We find maybe in various parties, there is disagreement, there are a move, there is what called alignment. And some alignment, maybe you are not happy with them, others you are happy with them. And these alignment, they have made you to be afraid because you are saying, what if my candidate do not win? What if my candidate is rejected? What if my candidate, this happened? What would my country be like? And majority of us, and even the church in general, is afraid. But one of the things we are forgetting is that the Bible says that do not let our feet be ensnared. Another thing we are saying is the fear of man, and this is the fear of known. The things that we may see. We may see we don't have money, may see we don't, the people, they reject us, they hate us. One of the things I go to encourage you, my brother and my sister, if you do not confront the dragon of fear, you are going to stagnate in your spiritual life. You are going to stagnate in your business. You are going to stagnate what your destiny. The Lord is saying that, have I not commanded you? Have I not commanded you to be strong and courageous? To be strong and courageous. Have I not said unto you, do not be afraid? If you are afraid, you shall stagnate and you shall stay in the wilderness for 40 years. There are some things I have seen God doing in my life. When God was calling me to ministry, He just challenged me maybe to live my normal way of life. I had to adjust in my job. And this adjustment, it was not easy for me. There was a lot of what if in my life, what if things do not work in my life, what if my children, they get sick, what if my wife gets sick, what if I get sick, who will pay my medical bills, who will pay maybe my rent, what about food, and many things. And this could always hold me captive. But when I confronted fear, I have seen the faithfulness of the Lord. I have seen the grace of the Lord. I may not have lived in the abundance as the world may say abundance, but I know what the Lord said in the book of Matthew chapter 6, I think starting from verse 25, that we should not worry what to eat or what to drink. We should not worry about our clothing. For the Bible says that we look to the birds of the air. These birds of the air, they do not plant, neither do they store in the barn. But our heavenly Father feeds them. And then he said, look to the lilies of the field. They do not weave or have clothing. But the Bible says that not even the King Solomon had such a spreader. And God challenged the people and he said to them, that who by worry can add a cubit in their life? And the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. And therefore, perhaps you are worrying about your clothing. Maybe you are worrying about your shelter. The Bible says, for heathen, the people who do not know God, they are afraid of this thing. They are concerned with those things. But the Bible says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, the righteousness. And all other these things, the Lord says, shall be added unto you. So my brother, my sister, this is the word of God. This is the challenge of God. Let us have the whole reference to Almighty God. Let our life be centered to the Almighty God. That our life, we shall not be driven by fear. But we are going to confront fear. When we confront fear, we shall be able to go and cross River Jordan. Behind you, the Pharaoh army may be behind you. Maybe ahead you, there is a Red Sea. On the side of your life, there is no escape road. And you are feeling, I cannot be able to move. My brother, my sister, do not be afraid. God is commanding you and telling you, march ahead, march ahead, march ahead. I do not know what you are going to confront. Maybe it is the fear of the family. Maybe it is the fear of your wife or your husband. Maybe it is the fear of marriage. Maybe it is the fear of starting another business. And you are seeing these are not working. The Lord is saying, move ahead, move ahead. Maybe you are just like Joshua and Caleb and the people who are spying the land. When you look around your life, around your ministry and everything, that you are surrounded by giants. I pray that you shall have a different spirit like Joshua and Caleb. And you say, the Lord will help me. So if you go ahead, the Lord will help you. The Lord will walk with you. And the Lord is going to empower you. The Lord is going to strengthen you. He is going to keep you safe because He is the Almighty God. And what is He repeating? I hear the Lord speaking to somebody. I hear the voice of God speaking to somebody saying that have I not commanded you? Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Be strong and courageous. Even in our ministry, we have so many needs in our ministry. There are so many areas we need to reach the world, doing the ministry, building the sanctuary, buying land, building mission centers, and all other things. We need all those things. And we may be afraid as if the vision is too big for us. But what is God saying? Have I not commanded you? Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. It may look we are in the time of famine, like the time I shared with you in the book of Genesis chapter 26, and we are finding there is famine in the land. The Lord is challenging us and telling us, my brother, my sister, plant even though you do not see any cloud. Plant even though you don't see any sign of rain. Oh, plant, for I will give you a hundredfold. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I am going to move with you. I am going to encourage you. I am going to empower you. I am going to open ways for you. I am going to open resources for you. I am going to bless your ministry. I am going to bless your marriage. I am going to do great things. For the Bible says that the Lord is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above what we imagine or what we ask, according to the power that worketh within us. So there is power that worketh within us. And when we release this power that worketh within us, it is going to drive away fear. It's going to drive away fear. The fear of no, the fear of unknown, the fear of men, the fear of the things we are thinking of. We are going to go ahead. We are going to slay the giant. We are going to slay Goliath because the heart of the Almighty God is within us. And then the Bible says, he who is in us is greater than the one who is in the world. So my brother, you are overcomer. My sister, you are overcomer. Go and overcome. Go and conquer. Go and move with the full anointing and grace of God. For the Lord our God is with us. Do not be afraid. Have I not commanded you? Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. As I was with Moses, so will I be with you. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. I know this is the word for me, and this is the word for you. I hear the Holy Spirit ministering to us. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. No one will be able to stand against you all the days of your life. I know no one will be able to stand against my calling, against my family, against my ministry, all the days of my life. Because the Lord is saying, as I was with Moses, so will I be with you. So my brother, my sister, let us move with boldness. Let us lay this dragon of fear. Let us go ahead. Has God commanded you to do something in the kingdom? Go and do it. Has God told you to do ministry? Go and do it. For the Lord your God is with you. So may the Lord God bless you. May the Lord God favor you. May the Lord increase his grace upon you. And may the Lord God Almighty be with you. I raise again the spirit of fear in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am making a declaration right now that the power of God shall rest upon you in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. As you are hearing this word, you are going to arise with courage in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You are going to go and slay the dragon of fear. You are going to occupy, you are going to do your business. You are going to occupy and you are going to rise as a victorious saint in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you are not born again, make this prayer after me. Father, I come before you. I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and my Savior. May I be strong to go and overcome in Christ Jesus. I decree this day I am born again in Christ Jesus. So God should bless you, God favor you, and God multiply grace upon you. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Bye-bye. Till we meet again for another encouraging one. God be with you. Amen.